Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to film a travel video about how to do the Komodo Island sailing cruise that I did this summer in Indonesia. I'm making this video because I just think that this trip is a really fun thing to do if you're solo traveling Indonesia or if you're just backpacking Indonesia with your partner or with friends. And when I was going on this trip, I researched it in blogs and everything, but I was missing kind of a more detailed explanation of the whole trip, and I just think that this video would have been really useful to me at the time, so I hope that this can help any of you out. And before I get into all the logistics of like how to do the trip and how much it costs, etc., I wanted to show a little montage of footage that I took while I was on the boat trip, just to give you an idea of what it's like and just to show off all the footage that I took, because it was a really fun trip and I met great people, and I hope that some of them are watching this. If you are, hello. So see you after the montage.
All of you sit with not the same time, but always.
Was me all along. Had a million conversations in my head about where it went wrong. And I've got no idea where you've been, who you are, not anymore. All I got is this Polaroid picture of us from June 24th. It's where I kissed you for the first time. Laid on your sheets, you gave me your heart and said you trusted with me. But all I did was let you down time and time again. It wasn't my intention. Maybe we should have been friends. So you're someone I used to know, but nobody said it'd be easy. Maybe I should have known. One more drink to swallow it down. I gotta get you out of my mind. But nobody said it was easy.
By the jealous way. Sound of freedom.
Welcome back. I hope that you enjoyed that little montage. And now I just want to get into a bit more specifics about the trip and how to do it, basically. And I just want to let you know I have my phone here that is recording the audio because I'm trying to improve the audio on my videos. And also I have a little list of all the stuff that I'm going to be talking about. So if I look down or like see my phone, that's what's happening. Yeah, so the first point is just what even is this trip? So the trip is a 4-day, 3-night, overnight trip on a boat in Indonesia where you sail from one island to another, from Lombok to Flores or vice versa. They also do it the other direction. And along the way, you stop at a bunch of different places and it's an adventure thing to do as a backpacker. You sleep on the boat, you eat on the boat, and during the day, you go on all these adventures off the side of the boat, basically. It costs about 2,800,000 Indonesian rupiah, and I know that sounds like a crazy amount, but remember, like, currency conversions. So basically that amount was approximately $180 at the time I did it, which was August 2022, and that was for the deck class. And you sleep on the deck with everybody else. And if you want to have cabin class, which is a bit more expensive, you have a cabin with one other person, then it's 3,300,000 Indonesian rupiah. And I think that that price is actually really affordable because it includes overnight. So it includes your accommodation and your food for 4 days and three nights. And if you look at it spread out over the whole time, it's like $45 a day, which is about what you would spend anyway if you were backpacker traveling. At least that's about what I would spend anyway. So overall, it doesn't really add costs, or at least not a lot, to your trip. And it's just really worth doing, in my opinion. So second thing is how to book it. So this trip is actually a type of tour that a lot of companies offer in Indonesia, but they really vary on safety standards and, yeah, kind of quality of what you get for the money. And so I recommend really doing thorough research about what's included. Are there life jackets on the boat? What does it stop at? And if you're going to Komodo National Park, which is a big highlight of this trip, is the entry fee to the park included in your price, like it should be? Because that's quite an expensive part of the trip and it should be included in the tour price in general. And it was in my case. And the company that I went with is called Wanua Adventures. And I've linked them below. You can contact them online or via their phone number, and I had a really good experience with them and had read a lot of positive reviews about them online as well. So I recommend going with them. So the next sort of question is, what do you actually end up doing day to day when you're on this boat? So most of the trip, I would say, is a mix of hiking, snorkeling, going to waterfalls, and swimming, and hanging out on the boat. And if those are things that you like to do, I think you'd really enjoy this. It's definitely water heavy, clearly, as you're on the boat. So I'd recommend it to people that, you know, like swimming, like being in the water, would enjoy swimming with sea turtles, which is one of my favorite things that we did, that sort of thing. You just see this incredible nature that you would otherwise never see, because it's just on this rugged coastline of Indonesia that you really can't reach apart from by boat. And the last thing that I want to cover is why this was so great, just a few reasons why it's great. So my first reason is actually that it was a relief as a solo traveler not to have to plan anything for 4 days, since this was all decided for you. You didn't have to book accommodations or look at hostel ratings online. It was all decided and it was great. I wouldn't have changed the itinerary even if I had made it myself. The next point is that it's a great way to meet people as a solo traveler. You know, the struggle of getting to the hostel and having to say, hi, my name's Ellie, I'm from XYZ, all the time. And on the boat, it was just really easy to make friends, and I made the nicest friends. Shout out to Ollie, Yulia, and Rachel, if you're watching this. And I just had so much fun getting to know them, and it's just, yeah, it's an easy way to connect with people because you're sleeping and living and being together for 24 hours, 4 days in a row. And another favorite moment of mine was the last night when we got off the boat. We all stayed in a hostel in Labuan Bajo in Flores, where you arrive, but we met up for dinner and had a fancy dinner at a restaurant together with people from the boat and partied afterwards. And it was just a really nice ending to the trip. And that's actually leads up to the last point that I wanted to cover, which was what you do before and after this cruise. How does this fit into your itinerary? So the cruise starts in Lombok usually and finishes in Flores, which is in the area where Komodo National Park is. So what a lot of people do is they fly to Bali, visit Bali, then cross over to Lombok either by boat or by plane, visit Lombok, and then start the trip in Lombok, do the boat trip, the 4 day, 3 night to Komodo Island, to Flores, and then land in Flores. And then you can either fly back to the west, back to Bali or Lombok or Jakarta, that type of thing, or continue on, which I really recommend doing, and staying in Flores for a few weeks and exploring that island. It's a bit less visited than Bali and Lombok, and I unfortunately wasn't able to spend a lot of time there on my trip this time. But if you have 2 weeks in your itinerary, I really highly recommend staying there and checking it out. I've heard so many good things. And when I go back to Indonesia, I'll definitely go there. People tend to do diving after this trip because the area around Labuan Bajo and Flores and Komodo National Park is really known for having amazing world-class dive sites. So people tend to do that afterwards as well. I'm just not into diving, so I didn't do that. But I kind of got tempted to start diving after this trip because everybody there was so into it. Yeah, that's kind of it. Honestly, I really hope that this video was somewhat informative to you. And if you do want to do this trip and have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. I'm happy to send you any more info on it. I was so excited to do it after reading blogs about it, and it really didn't disappoint. Yeah, one of my favorite experiences I've ever done traveling, for sure. Thanks for watching and thanks for coming to my channel. If you're here, please subscribe. Please feel free to give me feedback on my videos as well. I'm trying to like improve and just get better at making videos, make more videos. I just really enjoy this, and see you soon, hopefully. And have an amazing day wherever you are, whoever you are. Bye.
Okay.